Angular or React.js? Which should you learn? Which should you use for a project? And more importantly, what are the structural and fundamental differences between these two solutions? I've worked with Angular since 2016 and with React since 2019. And by Angular, I mean Angular 2 and later, not Angular.js. And to me, although the two serve a very similar purpose, they feel radically different to code with. The first point worth mentioning is that Angular is used on Gmail, on Google products in general, at Microsoft Office Online, at Upwork, at Sony, and at Forbes. React, on the other hand, is used at Facebook, at Instagram, Netflix, Dropbox, and Uber. The first thing to underline is that this means Angular and React are both mature solutions with strong references. However, these names, these companies, tell a story of two very different worlds, and they provide the first inkling of a clue about the underlying difference between the two solutions. In fact, the two logos tell a very similar story. Angular's logo is a shield, which has undertones of being safe and solid and secure. React's logo, on the other hand, is an atom. And if you combine the semantics of React and an atom, you get an explosion, an atomic reaction, which is kind of the polar opposite of safety and security. And the internal mission statements of these two companies building these two solutions show exactly that same opposition. Google, where Angular was created, claims to do no evil. Facebook, the birthplace of React, on the other hand, wants to move fast and break things. Where Google sounds very law-abiding and gentlemanly, Facebook's internal motto gives off a kind of rebellious bad boy vibe. And it seems to me that this opposition rubs off on the two solutions, that Angular and React each reflect or embody these two mindsets, these two mission statements. And if we take a closer look at the companies that use the two solutions, they tell pretty much the same story. Angular proudly boasts of solid and sensible companies like Sony and Forbes. Whereas the React champions, that is to say Dropbox and Netflix and Uber, are disruptive. They favor speed of execution over following established ways of doing things. Or to put it in other terms, they move fast and break things. If we were to translate this opposition into role-playing terms, Angular would have a lawful good alignment. And React would have a chaotic neutral one. And it's interesting to see how these opposing philosophies or mindsets translate into code, into how the solutions expect you to use them. On the React side, there's no pre-imposed structure. In fact, React doesn't even claim to be a framework, and frameworks provide structure. It's in the name. They provide a frame. No, React is simply a library, an engine that can be plunked into whichever structure you choose. In Angular, there's a coding and naming convention, which is derived from the MVC model. MVC stands for Model View Controller. The file system structure reflects this. Each module in Angular has a folder, and within the module folder, each component has its own folder. And all this structure needs to be followed if you want the application to compile, let alone function. React doesn't have an MVC structure in the code and doesn't impose a structure on the file system at all. In React, a component is just a function that renders HTML code directly, if we're using hooks and functional components, and I hope you are. In React, how to structure the code and the file system is left firmly in the developer's hand. And that actually comes at a cost. How you structure your code, which library you use for routing or translation or state management, all these choices are in the developer's hands. And choosing badly can be costly. In Angular, that cost of having to choose is gone. All the choices are made for you. Angular is batteries included. Routing, check. Translation, check. State, check. Angular has you covered. However, that structure and those batteries come at a cost too. All these libraries, all that functionality, needs to be understood and learned correctly. Where React can be learned in one productive afternoon, Angular takes quite a bit more time to cover. Now, how are Angular and React different in practice? In my experience, the differences in structure lead to bigger components with larger scope in Angular, whereas React leads to more focused components. Reusing components is also more complex in Angular, whereas doing so in React requires minimal effort. In React, everything feels more focused and more lightweight. Now, because Angular is a fully fledged framework with a much larger scope, it provides more functionality out of the box, like routing or translation or two-way state management, and it has a predefined structure, it has a steeper learning curve. React, on the other hand, is a focused library with way less structure and less scope. This makes it a lot easier to learn initially, because there's just less of it to learn. You can cover the main concepts in an afternoon. That single-minded focus is also what gives it greater flexibility. Angular provides security and structure, where React provides agility and speed. Now, which one do I recommend? To start with, I'd recommend learning JavaScript and TypeScript before learning either, and I have links in the description that can help with that. Now, once that's done, if you can, learn both. If you can't, my recommendation would depend on your personality traits, on how risk-averse you are, on how much structure you need. If you need things to be standardized and secure, I'd advise you go for Angular. If you need action and flexibility, I'd recommend you go for React. If you want a development career in the banking sector or a stable work environment, favor Angular. If you'd prefer to work in a startup where everything is moving in all directions, I'd recommend React. Both are good choices, but only you can answer which one fits where you want to go. And my next recommendation, click on this thumbnail. I'll see you in that video.